going to be making a 3D model of a vase given to us on Geogebra. First, I will be inserting the picture of the vase and put it on points where it matches. I will then make the transparency of the picture go less so I can pinpoint where the points are. After then, I'll be adding points. With these points, I will be starting putting in the different surfaces by first I'll do fit poly from C to E. Then I'll do F, press this one. The condition will be XC. And at the end, it'll be E. Here, I'll be writing what's here. It's F. Enter. And I will make this invisible. Next, I'll be doing the same but for E to G and G to I. Okay, so next what I'll be doing is adding a 3D graphics on the view, hide the points, and start putting in commands for surface so these will turn to shape, to 3D shapes. I'll put in surface, curve angle, the curve by it's talking about these are the curves. I'll put G for this one. The angle will be 2 pi, so it's round since the vase is leaning on its side. We put x-axis. I'll be doing the same for P and R. you can see, I have created the 3D vase. Oh, I've seen that. I've made the 3D vase in GeoGebra. All that's needed is to solve for the volume. And to do that, you can put in the volume command and press this one. I can press cylinder and type cylinder, and we can put the starting point and the end point of each surface. Since there are three surfaces, I will add up three cylinders. I'm gonna add up those three cylinders to create the to get the volume of the whole vase. For this one, it starts with C, ends in E, and the radius will be 2 pi, 299.51. Next one will be 2 pi, ending in G, and then 2 pi again. Then that's the volume for the center cylinder, and the last cylinder will be 2 G, next is I, I'll redo it since because of the pop-up, something happened. Okay. Next to the ending with I, then 2 pi. I'll get these values and then I'll add them up. Upon adding up the values, I got the value 862.62 cubic units.